One was such a success, and a lot of people have been coming back to me on Instagram or messaging me in the comment section. So if you have further questions about completing a JD, especially in Australia, I completed mine at the University of Sydney. Please leave a comment, ask me any questions, and I will get back to you in the comment section. You can talk to me on Instagram as well at liveshoptravel. Or I will make another video if enough people want to know this information. So I guess I really wanted to make these videos super informative. I wanted them to be somewhat, this is my experience of the law school, so this is not going to be representative of your experience when you go and do your degree. However, when I was researching universities, I found that there wasn't much information available from a student perspective and from a perspective of somebody who was actually looking to change careers, who was researching certain unis, who was coming, from an environment where they didn't grow up in Australia like myself. I did go to high school here, but I didn't really spend much time in Australia prior to that. So this is some advice as almost a friend who had that experience, who went through the 3 years of the Juris Doctor as a student, and I would like to share my experience with you, just because when I was researching universities, I didn't know who to ask. There wasn't much information available online. There weren't such informative YouTube videos or anything where I could just ask somebody about their experience. And the only resource that I had was really university websites, and it was just standard policy and guidelines, but you won't be able to ask these questions of career advisors or university administrative departments. So I wanted to make another video just to help you out a little bit. So let me know if you like this format, and I will continue. So one of the questions that keep coming up, and people ask me this a lot, is what is the average age of a JD student? Because obviously this is a postgraduate law degree, and you'd think, and this is what I thought, that a lot of people would be maybe in their 30s or late 20s, just because maybe somebody was changing careers, or they wanted to do law at a later stage in their life, just like I did. And, I thought that everybody would be in that age group of late 20s, early 30s, like myself. The majority of the students in my university were actually between the ages of 23 and 24, and that basically means that they graduated from their degree, undergraduate, whether it was arts or commerce or whatever they wanted to do, and then the second that they graduated from their undergrad, they would go straight into the JD. So that's one way that people got into law, and maybe they didn't want to do law before, or they didn't combine their courses, so they would jump straight into law, the JD degree, after they completed their undergrad. So that's why 23 to 24 was the majority of the people in my cohort. The next percentage would probably be late 20s, so maybe 26 to 27. And not so many people after 30, but you do get some notable exceptions, because we did have somebody in my classes that attended the lectures who was a retired or retiring doctor. So he was in his late 60s and wanted to do a law degree. So you will meet really interesting people in a JD like that. And there won't be a lot of them, but I think this is why the degree is quite interesting, because you do meet all kinds of people from different disciplines with potentially different careers, just like myself. I had a 8 to 9 year marketing career before I moved into law. So, you know, you will meet people like myself in these degrees, but the majority will be people who are 23, 24 and have just completed their undergrad. Now, the second question that I get asked a lot is, what was the mix of students like in the classrooms? The mix of students is usually, I would say, approximately 40% were international students. The majority of those students were students from China, and a lot of them actually were already law qualified in China, and they were coming to Australia to requalify or basically get a JD in a common law jurisdiction, and then you know, a lot of their credits would actually count towards this degree, so they actually graduated faster. They didn't have to do the full 3 years. They only had to do 2, I think, and a lot of the times, you know, people, international students were coming from that kind of background. Then there were a lot of people that were coming from Canada. There's a few students from Canada and the US, just because the JD is such a common thing in Canada and the US, and the Juris Doctor is actually a term used in the US and Canada, because over there you cannot do an undergraduate law degree. The only way that you can become a lawyer is through this postgraduate Juris Doctor degree. So you would need to complete an undergrad before and then move into the Juris Doctor. Whereas here you can be an undergraduate law student, you just have to combine the law with another discipline. And so you have 5 years in total studying and doing a combined degree. It's what it's called, the LLB. So the JD is 3 years, and then if you want to do it as an undergraduate, that's 5 years. So yeah, the majority of students were internationals. So when it comes to internationals, majority were from China, and then there were lots of other countries. Basically, this program attracts students from all over the world. And there was a lot of people who, I think, as internationals, were getting that extra support from another, almost like a community of international students, which I think is nice. So I think, you know, if you're an international student and you're thinking of coming to Australia to do the Juris Doctor specifically, there is a big community of international students, so you will be able to integrate quite easily, and yeah, it's an interesting degree to do over here. If you like this video, please click subscribe and don't forget to hit the bell button. Comment below and follow me on Instagram, and keep watching as I reveal my third most common question, whether the JD is hard or not. So as I mentioned, the program itself is 3 years if you do it full time. It's quite an intense program, and a lot of people have asked if it's difficult. This was definitely one of the hardest things that I had to do. I've studied for the GMAT before. I did the GMAT twice to get to the score that I wanted. I studied commerce at the University of Auckland. That's my first degree. I mean, you know, there were times that those disciplines were really hard, but I thought the JD was actually a whole other ball game. So if you've got an undergrad and you thought that that was a difficult discipline, the Juris Doctor will push you. It'll push you harder. Law is not hard. Contrary to what a lot of people think, the law itself is actually not that difficult. You don't have to be some genius. I mean, there's a lot of smart people that go into the profession, but you don't have to be, you know, an absolute genius to get into law and to understand it and to be good at it. It's the volume of material that's actually the hardest part. And the fact that you have to squeeze it all in 3 years, and plus you need to try and figure out, you know, what kind of profession you want after that. Do you want to be a lawyer? Do you want to then do a clerkship, as I explained in my previous video? And, you know, where do you want this career? Where do you want this profession to take you? So that's a lot to figure out in 3 years, especially if you're trying to study and get good grades. You're trying to possibly do an internship, a clerkship, and work as a paralegal to get the experience. And you're also trying to, you know, juggle a lot of personal things in your life, and there really is not much time for that. On top of that, it's recommended that you do certain things like competitions at uni and mooting and all of that. I would highly recommend that you get involved in all of these activities because they do teach you a lot. But it's just the combining of all of the things plus the volume of the material and this constant, you know, assignments, tests, grades. You have to participate a lot in class, and then the exams are quite grueling and quite challenging, especially at USID, just because a lot of them are closed book. But I can do a video on that later if you're interested. So yeah, the JD is challenging. It's 3 years of your life that will be full on, but it is rewarding. And you know, if you don't want to do it full time, if it's something that you start, and a lot of my friends have kind of done this, where they've started as a full-time JD student, then they got a job or they decided, look, I don't actually want to finish it in 3 years, there's no rush. They would move to a part-time course, and you know, there's night classes, and so you can extend that degree as you go along. So if you find it too intense, or if you find that life gets in the way, as it does, you can always go to part-time and finish it, not in 3 years, but in 4 or 5 years. And you know, you could have a great experience with that as well. And my belief really is that I have no regrets doing the JD. I thought it was a fantastic program. You need to enjoy it. It's not 3 years of your life that you want to completely sacrifice to the law and say, that's it, I'm gonna bed it down, I'm gonna, you know, sacrifice my entire life, say goodbye to friends, say goodbye to family and holidays and weekends. But it's not like that. I think you need to really understand what's valuable to you during this process. You'll learn a lot, you'll be challenged, you'll be pushed, but it's by no means designed to be something that completely destroys you as a person, because if it does, and if you feel that way, maybe that's not the right mentality, and maybe that's not the right degree for you, because it shouldn't feel like that. The 3 years that I spent doing the JD were challenging. I really enjoyed myself through the process as well, so I think that's why I was able to get through it. If I didn't think that the time for me was enjoyable and I wasn't getting anything out of it, I was just sacrificing myself, I don't think it's worth it in the long run. So you make that decision. But I hope that this session was informative and you learned a bit more about this degree. And hopefully I've helped you get closer towards a decision on whether you should study law or not. So thanks for watching, and if you have any questions, please comment down below. Subscribe to this channel, because I'll be making many, many more videos like this as I discovered that, you know, I really want to be helpful. And yeah, hopefully you enjoyed this, and see you next time.